Welcome back to Daily Devotions from Mount Calvary Lutheran Church. My name is Pastor Andrew Howe. It's a joy to be with you today as we continue our journey through Luther's small catechism, exploring the six chief parts of the Christian faith, the six essential teachings of the church that really help summarize the things that we need to pass on to our children. In fact, when Luther wrote the Catechism, he had intended it for parents, especially fathers, to teach the faith, the basic Christian essential truths of the Christian faith, and ultimately distinguishing between law and gospel. This week, we've been talking about a very interesting topic of confession. Confession is obviously two parts, that we acknowledge that we're sinful to God and that we also confess it and repent. And obviously, our Lutheran order of worship regularly has this part of the worship service at the beginning, and that's intentional, that we are coming into God's house to confess our sins and to also be reminded in the stead and by the command. The pastor offers that word of absolution, or God's forgiveness. And, you know, I've met a few people from time to time that have an issue with that. And part of it is just misunderstanding. Why does the pastor offer those words of absolution? Why does it say, in the stead and by the command of my Lord Jesus Christ, I forgive you, when Jesus is the one who did all the work on the cross? And that's true. But back in the Gospels, Jesus says, I have given you the keys to the kingdom, and part of that is the stewardship of the forgiveness of sins. If Jesus says, if they are repenting of their sins, you are to forgive them. And we know that it comes from him. And that's why in the corporate absolution, it goes very carefully, in the stead as a called and ordained servant of Christ, and in the stead and by the command of my Lord Jesus Christ. It's all these little things that remind the people, why is the pastor doing it? Today we're going to talk a little bit about private confession and absolution. What I've been walking through mostly this week has been what we would refer to as corporate or in a congregational worship service setting, but private confession and absolution. And I try to encourage people in my congregation that this is always available, and a number of people do take advantage. You know, in my office, you know, there's a sofa, and I have my office chair, and I always like to sit across. And I know that's totally different than if in Catholic circles with the confessional booth. And obviously there would maybe be a little bit more discreet, but my ministry is always built on relationship. And, you know, even if you don't know me very well, but you live in Warner Robins here and you want to find a way to have a safe place to confess sin, my office is always safe, you know. And maybe the question is, how can I be sure what I say to the pastor will remain confidential? When I was ordained almost a decade ago now, I in our Lutheran Church Missouri Synod, in our ordination vows, we promise before God never to divulge the sins that have been confessed to us. Never means never, for God himself in Christ has removed these sins. You know, I want you to know, and anybody watching this to know, that I'm a safe place for you to confess sins. I would much rather you come and confess your sin than to keep it and hold on to it. Because I think Satan will poke and prod at that. And that's essentially why God has called pastors to help facilitate God's people to leave our sins at the cross. And that's how I always view confession absolution. Whether you're in my office or we're in the church service setting, we're there to leave it at Jesus' feet, because that's where we know the penalty of those sins has been paid for. Psalm 103, verse 12 says this, as far as the east is from the west, so far does he remove our transgression from us. So what benefit is there to have this private confession absolution? You might be thinking, I thought that's the whole point of the Reformation. We were reforming not to be so much Catholic, but this seems like a Catholic practice. In individual confession, the Christian has a safe place to name his or her sins so that they are no longer carried alone. And I was talking about that just a few minutes ago. And then when that has taken place, then I get to do one of the most favorite things in my entire job is to announce the grace of Jesus. I forgive you all your sins. I'm standing there as Christ's representative to remind you that you have been paid for, your sins have been paid for on the cross, and your sins are forgiven. And there's freedom in that. There's Christian freedom. Christ didn't come in the world to condemn the world, and that's how I view private confession and absolution. I'm not here to condemn you. I'm not here to judge you. I am here to guide you and lead you to lay your sins at Jesus' feet and to remind you, as a dear child, loved by your heavenly Father and redeemed by your Savior Jesus, your sins are forgiven in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. I pray that wherever you are, maybe you're watching this and you attend another congregation, is to find that relationship and that safe place. Maybe it's your pastor. Even pastors are encouraged to what we call have our father confessor. And I regularly make contact with several of mine to remind myself that, I'm sinful just like everyone else. And we all need that safe place to not hold on to our sin, to find that safe place, but to leave it at Jesus' feet, and to have a pastor come alongside you and to remind you your sins are forgiven by the blood of Christ. I pray that that blesses you and frees you and allows an opportunity for you to get that off your chest. Will you pray with me? Lord Jesus, the practice of individual confession absolution is a sacred gift, one in which we do not take lightly, where we have the opportunity to have that safe place to leave our sin, where it's been paid for on the cross, but also to receive your holy word of absolution, your forgiveness won by Jesus on the cross. And I pray that we would always be mindful of living repentant-filled lives, but also focused on the forgiveness that you've promised and secured through our baptism, which is connected to your work on the cross. We pray this in Jesus' name.